everyone. I'm Ruth Bram, and I've been at Oculus since 2014, working as an executive producer on the Oculus Studios team. Over the years, I've been able to help our developer partners create engaging games and entertainment experiences for a wide variety of gamers like you. It's absolutely incredible to see just how far we've come in such a short time. 2020 was a really successful year for our developer community, and that's all thanks to you. We've taken cues from what you've liked or wished were better as we continue to develop our 2021 content. And it's a big year for VR. Today, I'm here to share a look at new trailers, info on upcoming titles, and updates to community favorite games and IPs. So welcome to our very first Oculus Gaming Showcase. Now, back in September at Facebook Connect, I shared with you some news about the upcoming launches of Pistol Whip 2089, Warhammer 40K Battle Sister, Star Wars Tales from the Galaxy's Edge, and The Climb 2. These games have all since launched, but thanks to all of your feedback, the developers behind these games have listened. And today we're going to dive into some new updates about each of them. And for those of you who tuned into Capcom's Resident Evil 25th Anniversary Showcase last week, you also heard that we're going to be sharing more details about Resident Evil 4 coming to the Oculus Quest platform, including exclusive gameplay video. So you don't want to miss that. Today, you'll also get the latest on Lone Echo 2, Star Wars Pinball, Wraith the Oblivion Afterlife, and a few other titles, as well as get the scoop on a brand new title coming to the Quest platform that might just give you a little bit of nostalgia. Let's dive in with Pistol Whip. Last holiday, Cloudhead Games released 2089, a gritty cinematic sci-fi campaign that brought new content and music collaborations to Pistol Whip fans. You all loved it so much that the team is back at it again, guns blazing, with another five-scene, narrative-driven, action-packed campaign.
So you're the scoundrels calling yourselves Dynamo, huh? Well, I think I might just call you dead. I'm coming for you, Tess.
Smoke and Thunder tells the tale of two sisters set in the Wild West, where trains, tech, and explosions set the scene for some exciting surprises. This update is releasing alongside the Concierge, which will unlock total customization for Pistol Whip players. Endless combinations of weapons and modifiers for every level will allow you to truly hone your playstyle. Whether you prefer bottomless burst pistols or dodging through levels as a no-ammo pacifist, keep an eye out for Smoke and Thunder and the Concierge coming this summer. Last month, Pixel Toys brought Horde mode to Warhammer 40K Battle Sister with their Last Bastion update, featuring a brand new map and leaderboards to compete against your friends' top scores on the Quest platform. They have a couple more surprises in store for you today, so check this out.
The Sororitas will cleanse this place!
Starting today, it'll be on Rift, and you and your friends can team up to play Last Bastion in co-op on two brand new maps, now with cross-play and cross-buy support for Quest and Rift platforms. I know you all have been waiting patiently for this next one, but I can now share that we are launching Lone Echo 2 this summer on the Rift platform and for those playing on the Quest platform with Link. Utilizing all of your favorite mechanics from Lone Echo, in Lone Echo 2, you'll return to the Rings of Saturn to explore an expansive zero-G world, employ high-tech tools to overcome challenges, and uncover the mysteries of the far future. been watching the progress on this game throughout development, and as a Lone Echo fan since 2017, I can't wait for you to play this. Next, I'd like to dive deep on a Quest 2 exclusive. As I mentioned earlier, if you weren't tuned into Capcom's Resident Evil 25th Anniversary Showcase last week, here's the scoop. We're bringing Resident Evil 4 to Quest 2 later this year. Resident Evil 4 originally debuted in 2005 on GameCube, and in the 16 years since launch, it's continued to inspire games, movies, and the survival horror genre. Now, the content of the game's not going to change. We wouldn't mess with such a winning formula. But we also don't consider this a traditional port. My colleagues at Oculus Studios are working closely with Armature and Capcom to rework the entire game for VR. Every corner of the world is being enhanced and remastered to feel fresh and exciting to OGs and to new fans alike, by ratcheting up the suspense as only VR can. The most obvious differences between playing RE4 in VR and on console is the shift in perspective and interactivity. Only on Quest 2 will you be able to play RE4 from Leon's first-person perspective. And the touch controllers will allow you to interact with the world in a fundamentally new way from how it's played on console. For example, items and weapons have been re-engineered to become physical objects that players can interact with, so that you can pick up things like ammo, keys, and treasures, as well as load, aim, and fire weapons in VR. You'll also be able to switch weapons by grabbing them off your body instead of going into a menu. And you can wield separate weapons with each hand. Even RE4's famous menu is no longer a pause screen. It's an interactive tool. A ton of effort has gone into making weapon interactions smooth, satisfying, and responsive, including two-handed weapons like shotguns and rifles. Let's talk about the movement system now. We didn't want the shift from third to first person to change the fundamental way Leon moves or collides with the world. You'll still move in first person by using the analog stick, but Armature has added a full upper body rig on top of Leon's character to combine his movement with the dual-handed interactivity achieved with touch controllers. If you don't want to use the analog stick to move freely, Armature even added support for teleportation, as well as room scale movement so that you can explore the environment with natural motion. And of course, one of our top priorities is to ensure the experience is comfortably played while seated, and with a ton of comfort options at your disposal to try out. As I mentioned earlier, RE4 debuted on GameCube 16 years ago, so you might be wondering, how in the world are we bringing the core systems from the original over to Quest 2? Well, first, it takes passion. The teams at Oculus Studios, Armature, and Capcom are all longtime fans of the game who are accepting only the best results. And it takes time. We've been working on this title for a couple years now, and just carefully and reverently making changes that will make your experience feel both fresh and nostalgic. Technically speaking, Armature is using core systems from the original RE4 to drive gameplay and systems, but they've remastered art. Over 4,500 textures have either been repainted or up-resed. World geometry has been adjusted to work in stereoscopic 3D. And enemy behaviors and attacks have been balanced around the player's new perspective to increase mobility in VR. They've also improved support for running the game at a higher frame rate than the original 30 frames per second, and fixed many bugs that the 60 FPS versions of the game had. Now, while Armature has adjusted a number of things for VR, some things just haven't needed to change. Character animations have been faithfully converted to Unreal Engine 4, and remain untouched from the original source material. And all cutscenes will be presented in their original format. If you're a fan of the survival horror genre like me, you've likely played, or tried to play, a lot of scary games in VR. Now, RE4 isn't known for being the scariest in the Resident Evil franchise, but it is scarier and more suspenseful in VR thanks to spatial audio and immersive interactivity. Armature has manipulated aspects of the original RE4 audio data and have used it instead as 3D spatial sound. So when you hear noises like crows, voices, and creaks, you're going to want to turn your head to see if there's a threat. They've also made sure that audio telegraphs from enemies to indicate which direction they're attacking from. So where on console you might have heard a Ganado approaching and rather calmly press buttons to reload and prepare a takedown, in VR, you're checking your ammo, you're scrambling to load a mag. And if you drop it, you're only adding to the stress and suspense of the situation by needing to physically correct your mistakes. You'll be living in the moment, carefully tracking ammo and inventory, relying on your senses for success more than you've ever done before. I'll leave you with this. A huge part of the RE4 fame was the elaborate cinematics that sell and tell the story. But once you come out of a cinematic in VR and find yourself face to face with the boss, the experience is totally different. I could talk for a lot longer about this game, but we've got to move on because there is more to share today. But stay tuned for more Resident Evil 4 updates in the lead up to its launch on Quest 2 later this year. All right, now I'd like to share with you updates on two of my favorite titles, because who doesn't love Star Wars? Last fall, ILMX Lab launched part one of Star Wars Tales from the Galaxy's Edge on the Quest platform. The story, set in a galaxy far, far away, brought us to the planet of Batuu to adventure and connect us face to face with some awesome characters. Both new, like Cecil Slack, and iconic, like C-3PO and R2-D2. Thanks to all the fans who fought against the Guavian Death Gang and shared feedback along the way, because ILMX Lab is now hard at work on Part 2, which expands the core adventure and will feature two more legendary tales for fans to enjoy. On behalf of ILMX Lab, I'm excited to share that one of the characters you'll get to meet in Part 2, a visitor from the Den of Antiquities, Doc Ondar. As one of the producers on this game, I personally can't wait for you to check it out. We'll be launching later this year. You might be able to guess where I'm headed with this next announcement. Star Wars Pinball. One of our Oculus Studios leads actually has an entire room at his house filled with rows of real pinball tables. It's pretty incredible, but not all of us have such a cool setup. In Star Wars Pinball, however, you can customize your own fan cave with memorabilia made especially for Star Wars Pinball VR. The game lets you relive some of your favorite iconic moments from Star Wars films and TV through 8 unique VR-optimized pinball tables, including new tables from The Mandalorian and classic collectibles. This is one I'm definitely adding to my wish list so that I'm ready to challenge my friends on the leaderboards next week when Star Wars Pinball launches on the Quest platform. Let's take a look behind the scenes to see how this experience came to life in VR.
We at Zen Studios are thrilled to bring you Star Wars Pinball VR, collecting our favorite Star Wars tables, classic and brand new, for the best virtual reality pinball package in the galaxy, all set within a true Star Wars fan's ultimate dreamland. We can't wait for you to play all 8 tables featured in Star Wars Pinball VR, including 2 brand new ones built from the ground up specifically to debut as VR tables. Of course, how could we not do The Mandalorian? It covers highlights from the entire first season. Also created to debut in Star Wars Pinball VR, Classic Collectibles is a really unique concept meant to evoke the nostalgic feeling of playing with old Star Wars toys. Meanwhile, we've overhauled our 6 classic tables to fit into virtual reality. Star Wars Pinball VR requires you to choose whether you favor the light or are perhaps drawn to the power of the dark side of the Force. A choice that contributes to an online galactic high score tug of war. Star Wars Pinball VR occasionally offers playable mini-games, which were fun the first time around, but they really shine in VR. Being huge fans ourselves, we didn't want to stop the immersion with awesome pinball. We wanted a whole huge entire room most of us could only dream of having. We call it the Fan Cave. You'll have a chance to customize all the memorabilia to your liking. You're able to move in here yourself on April 29th, when Star Wars Pinball VR is finally available. Thanks for joining us, and may the Force be with you.
That's all the Star Wars updates for now, but speaking of fan favorites, Shell Games is returning with a sequel to their popular spy-themed VR puzzler, I Expect You to Die. They've now got us on a brand new mission going deep undercover to investigate Zorax's next play for world domination. Everyone, including me, who played the original, knows firsthand what it feels like to be an elite secret agent in VR. And all of us at Oculus are excited to see this become even more of a reality. And I Expect You to Die 2, The Spy and the Liar. It'll be on Rift and Quest platforms later this year.
Welcome back, Agent. It's time to get back into the field. There's been an uptick in Zorax's activity, so you've got a lot of work to do. We're counting on your skill and cunning. And this time, Agent, you must be ready for anything. Or anyone.
From one imposter to another, break a leg.
You haven't heard about this next one, but it may bring back some nostalgia. If you remember 1080 snowboarding, it defined a genre of extreme sports games. Creators Giles Goddard has returned with Chewy Labs to bring you a modern take on this Nintendo 64 classic. Here's an exclusive first look at Carve Snowboarding. The team behind Arizona Sunshine is about to take VR by storm yet again with a brand new action-packed first-person shooter called After the Fall. Set in post-apocalyptic LA after hell has frozen over, you'll get to take on a new breed of ferocious undead. And up to four-player co-op means you won't have to do it alone. The synthwave soundtrack that plays as hordes of undead approach and the iconic 80s tech-turned weaponry are just a couple of the unexpected retro elements that make this game so unique. I got to check this one out early in development, and it was awesome even then. It's definitely on my wish list. I know you all love exclusives, so here it is for After the Fall.
I think we've got incoming.
Be on your guard.
Let's go.
Eater, nearby.
Get down!
Incoming!
Time to shine!
After the Fall is coming to Quest and Rift platforms with crossplay support later this year. We've covered a lot already, but up next, we have a couple games that you can try tomorrow. One of the first games I produced when I started at Oculus was a horror game. Horror is one of my favorite genres, and I'm always interested in playing the latest and greatest to see if it can top my last scare. So for all of you horror fans like me, there is a new one coming. So on our showcase today, we're excited to premiere the launch trailer for Wraith: The Oblivion Afterlife. This new exploration horror title from Fast Travel Games is set in the world of darkness, where you play as a wraith who must use his supernatural powers to unravel secrets and solve the mystery behind the Barclay Mansion. It's launching tomorrow on Quest and Rift platforms.
What is this place?
What's the matter?
Don't you recognize yourself?
There was a seance of sorts, but here we are. Dead. You're different now. The senses are more refined, sharper. What is dying good for if you don't adapt to it? Is that blood? Did you murder dear Rachel?
Please.
The house will let us leave. There has to be a way out somewhere.
Up next, we have one of my favorites. The Climb is actually one of our oldest and most popular games that my team was a part of. I remember when it first launched back in 2016 on Rift with just the gamepad. Then Crytek added touch support, and it's been a VR favorite ever since. The Climb 2 launched last month on the Quest platform. Now, in real life, I'm not a huge fan of heights, let alone hanging off the side of a mountain. But thanks to this game, I can say that I've built up a lot of confidence by climbing mountains and extremely difficult surfaces in some of the most beautiful locations in the world, minus the physical risk or money I'd have to spend in real life. I've really enjoyed some memorable experiences, all from the comfort of my own home. If you haven't tried it out yet, The Climb 2 features free solo climbing in breathtaking landscapes and with the thrill of leaderboard competition. Tomorrow, The Climb 2 is launching their Freestyle Expansion Pack. This pack will be released in two parts with 12 levels total, with the first introducing 6 new levels that will challenge you in both casual and professional modes. There won't be any checkpoints, and completing levels without chalk will get you bonus points. Among the variety of fun challenges this pack offers, we're introducing rhythm-based climbing, where you'll see disappearing grips along your route, requiring you to learn the grip patterns to the beat of a background track to progress through. I just finished trying it out, and clearly I'm not as good of a climber as I thought I was. I'm definitely gonna have to build up some more skills. But if you're up for the challenge, you won't need to wait long for it, because the first part of the Freestyle Expansion Pack goes live tomorrow, April 22nd, on the Oculus Store. And it's free. We have one last announcement in store for you today from our good friends at Skydance Interactive. Let's see what's next for the hit action horror experience, The Walking Dead: Saints and Sinners.
High alert, all tower troops. Receiving reports of a large stockpile of supplies from... This can't be right. A large stockpile of supplies from the reserve.
The whole thing is wired to blow. We'll smoke her out.
Your lazy shit-heel attitude has cost us even more supplies.
Heavy reclaimed presence looting National Guard cash. Bravo Company sustained severe casualties. Backup requested.
Savage has had the presence of mind to walk off with the key to this cash. Got his legs blown off for the trouble.
Shelter in the school to avoid our wrath. Oh, suckling pigs. Their screams will warn me.
This time, lock it down before the tourist gets there.
Thanks so much for joining me for our first Oculus Gaming Showcase. Be sure to check out the Oculus Store for our Showcase Flash sale, as well as new collections and game bundles. We'll have more gaming announcements throughout the rest of the year that we look forward to sharing with you. But in the meantime, Stay safe and keep playing.